Coming up on today's show.
I felt the love of God pour into my heart, and it was what I was looking for. My whole life I was searching for that.
All of that and more on today's show.
The show. Thank you for being with us. And now we have Rocky Lowther with us, and he has a powerful testimony.
Welcome, Rocky, to the show.
Thank you.
So I need to ask, what was your first service at Grace Cathedral?
Well, back in 1954, I was born with a growth on my bronchial tube. And the family was afraid that I was going to die. So they decided, they heard about Reverend Angley coming to Akron, Ohio, and I had a great uncle that actually drove us up, and they brought me to get prayed for.
Wow.
How old were you?
Well, I was born in March, and it was, I think he came in June.
Wow, you were young.
So it was back in the tent days.
Uh-huh.
And
you were just in diapers.
Yeah. You were just a couple months old.
Yeah. Yeah, they kept me in an oxygen tent. Had a,
mm-hmm. Wow.
Yeah, yeah, it sounds like it was very serious.
It was.
So then Reverend prayed for you, right?
Prayed for me, and I got a fantastic miracle.
Mm-hmm. Obviously, now you're
still here. Been in the ministry. Been here at Grace Cathedral for 65 years.
That's wonderful, Rocky.
Yeah.
And you're a singer and a songwriter.
Yeah.
And how many songs have you written?
I've written over 500.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
That's amazing. Now, when you started out, you didn't even know how to play an instrument, correct?
No. Back when I was 10 years old, I got my first guitar. I also got saved back then at 10 years old. And then from there on, I just kept using my talents for the Lord. And he just kept blessing me till I learned over 21 different instruments.
That's amazing. Yeah.
So today you play 21 different instruments.
Yeah.
Wow. How did you go about getting saved? I mean, what was the...
Well, that's a good question. Back when I was 10, I didn't want my peers to think that I was small, you know, walking down to the altar and giving my heart to the Lord. And I just decided, the Holy Spirit was moving on me, so I just decided, you know what, I got to get saved. So my mom was with me. She took me down to the altar, and Reverend Angley came over. He was praying with the people and stuff, and he came over. My mom says he needs to get saved. So,
and that was 55 years ago.
Yeah. That was a long time ago. And so he had me raise my hands, and I went through the sinner's prayer, got saved.
It's wonderful.
Yeah.
And that inspired you to write a song, correct?
Yes, it did. Yeah, I wrote the song, I Got Saved, and I tell about that experience in the song. And I was in prayer time, and the Lord brought that to my mind about it. I thought, you know what? I'm gonna write a song about this. I got saved. So that was my hook. That's how you usually get a song. You get a hook.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Then you just start writing about your experience.
Well, it's a powerful experience, and I love that song.
Yes, it is. Very powerful.
Now, do you do more than just write the song? Because there's a lot more to put a song together than just writing the song.
Yes. Whenever you write a song, you get your hook first, then you get your melody. Songs come in different ways. It doesn't mm-hmm. usually come the same way all the time. And the first thing I do once I have the hook and the melody, I go into the studio and I just start laying down the guitar with it.
Mm-hmm.
And then I started adding instruments, bass guitar, lead guitar, acoustic, and piano, whatever it needs to do that song. And to me, it's a lot of fun. Mm-hmm. A lot of fun laying down each instrument and
feeling it build layer after layer.
Yes.
Yes. It's
just
wonderful.
Putting the song together. You can't do something like that unless God is with you, mm-hmm. and He helps you with your talent. And I would like to say to the young people, if you're picking up an instrument and you're trying to learn and you're wanting to use it for the Lord, use it for the Lord. Mm-hmm. Don't use it anywhere else. Use it for His work.
Yeah, that's great advice.
Yeah.
Really good advice. Well, we want to listen to the song now.
Okay.
So we're going to go ahead and take a listen to it.
Okay. I didn't want to talk to him, didn't want to be bothered. I was lost in sin. Lost my best friend. Every single day that went by, I kept telling self I'd be alright. I needed him. Oh, I needed him. I didn't have an appetite for the Word of God that night. I just came for fun. So lost and undone. The preacher gave an altar call, but I didn't want to look so small. I needed him. Oh, I needed him. I finally reached out with a heart full of sin. He gave me a chance to invite him in. I got saved. I got Jesus in my heart. I got old time religion. Oh, the love He did impart. I got saved. I got really born again. Set free by Jesus' blood. Oh, the joy that He brought in. I got saved. I got Jesus in my heart. I got old time religion. Oh, the love He did impart. I got saved. I got really born again. Set free by Jesus' blood. Oh, the joy that He brought in. I got saved. Praise God. I got saved.
Well, that was a wonderful song, Rocky. And I do have to say my aunt loves your singing, and she lives about an hour and a half away, and she would have to have a CD of your songs so she could listen to them all the way home. So she just loves your music, and you've touched a lot of souls down through the years with your songs. They've really blessed people.
Well, thank the good Lord.
Yeah. So you've traveled with Reverend?
Yes, back in 1974. He started traveling. And for 2 years, we took cars. Mm-hmm. And at one time, we took a van, started carrying a lot of equipment with us. And then 1976, we got a bus, and I started, we got two buses and two trucks.
When you first started, Rocky, how many people were traveling with Reverend?
I think 17.
Okay, so he had a group of 17 people.
Yeah.
And then how many would work? Some would work the cameras, and some would work the invalid section? How did it actually work?
Well, I started out as a musician, mm-hmm. and I drove a truck. Mm-hmm. And we would go to all these different auditoriums. We hit mainly the South, and we played live music. And
that's wonderful.
I even got into a little bit of camera work, mm-hmm. running, being a cameraman. Mm-hmm. But my main function was playing the guitar, driving the truck, and it was a lot of hard work.
Yeah.
We would unload trucks. We'd drive to like Charlotte, North Carolina, mm-hmm. unload the truck, take a shower, go out on the stage. We'd get done like 3 o'clock in the morning.
Wow.
Load the truck back up again. Drive for 4 hours. We drove in shifts. And it was tough.
It was tough, but it was glorious because of the yeah. souls that you won.
Yeah, that's true.
That's what it's yeah. all about.
Yeah, I've met a lot of people. I've met a lot of preachers. Mm-hmm. And it was some experience to be traveling all over the place. Mm-hmm. I've been to 35 of states. And I was telling Kathy earlier, been to 35 countries. We traveled all through Canada from the East Coast all the way to Vancouver, West Coast. And put a lot of miles, we put over 1,000,000 miles just on the vehicles.
Wow.
So yeah, it's quite a journey.
So pretty yeah. much you would, Friday night, you'd have service here, and then you guys would take off.
Yes.
And then you'd come back, what, Sunday night or something, or
We would
Monday
come
morning?
Back Sunday night, because we had the first 2 years, we had when we had to get back by Monday so we could go to our jobs. And it got so bad, we were pulling in, going right to work, not even going home.
Mm-hmm.
And talk about tough. That was pretty tough.
Well, you know the Lord's with you because he had to give you the strength.
Yeah.
And you think about how the Lord gave you that miracle when you're just a babe in arms.
Yeah.
And if you wouldn't have received that miracle, where would you be today? You probably wouldn't have made it.
That's true.
So he saved your life.
Yeah.
Saved you at age 10. Blessed yep. you with the talent to play music and write songs, and now you're blessing others and helping others find Jesus.
Thank the good Lord.
Yeah, I think that's wonderful.
It is. Yeah, and quite a journey all these years.
Mm-hmm. When did you start choir?
I started choir back in 1966. I was 12 years old, but Angel wouldn't let me sing till I was a teenager. Mm-hmm.
And Angel is Reverend Angley's wife, late wife.
Right. Mm-hmm. So I sang until she passed away. And then that's when afterwards Reverend started up a quartet and started putting together a crew and stuff so we could mm-hmm. start traveling.
Well, I'm sure you inspired a lot of the youth during that time. Being saved and filled with the Holy Ghost and playing music for the Lord, I'm sure it was an inspiration to them.
Very much, yeah. Yeah.
And that's why it's important for the young to get in there, serve the Lord with your whole heart, and let the Lord give you the talents needed to work for Him.
Right. I'd like to say something to the young people. Don't hang with the wrong crowd. If you hang with the wrong crowd, you're going to act like them. Mm-hmm. You want to make sure you stay in there with God, hang with good people,
mm-hmm.
people you go to church with. And, yeah.
Right. It's true. You do end up acting like the people you hang around.
Yeah.
Well, this was a great, great segment. And Rocky, what a huge blessing you are to this Jesus ministry.
Well, thank you.
There's so many talents that you have that I just can't believe how many talents you do have.
It's over 500 songs written.
That's a lot
amazing.
Of songs.
Yes.
You know, people don't realize how long a song takes to put on paper and then produce and everything, and you do it all. and plus playing those songs.
Yeah.
You know, playing the music for those songs. So what a huge blessing.
I just thank good Lord on you. He's letting me do it.
We're blessed to have you. Yes. Friend, I'd like you to stay tuned because we'll be back in a little bit with more.
Coming up next.
I was a backslider, and he was married to me, and he was waiting for me to come home.
How would you like a friend with supernatural powers? Someone who can protect you from the dangers of this crazy world? Someone who can whisper love and encouragement when fear overwhelms you? Someone who can guide you through life's storms and, most of all, will never leave you? Maybe you think all of this is crazy. Well, why not reach today for the person of the Holy Ghost? And yes, He will become your best friend. So come to the worship center at our website. He's waiting for you, and He's so excited to meet you.
This is the power of God. This is the power of God. This is the power of God. This is the power of God.
All things are possible to him that believeth.
Thank God for the
Jesus
love.
Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever.
Hallelujah. My whole life, I was searching for something. And I didn't know what it was. And I felt like I had a big hole in my heart. And I tried to fill it with a lot of things, but I always had a tender spot for the Lord. I always wanted God, but I fell away. And I didn't even realize it. And that was the scary part. Is that I didn't even realize that I was without the Lord. I was a backslider, and he was married to me, and he was waiting for me to come home. He was waiting, just like the prodigal son. When his father saw him in the distance, he ran to meet him and greeted him, because his son that was lost was now found.
Wow, Anna, you have a wonderful testimony. But before you go into that, I did want to ask you, how did you first come to Grace Cathedral?
Well, to start off with, I think I always had a hunger for God, even when I was little. And when I was a very young teenager, I didn't want to live anymore. I had a lot of suicide thoughts, and I was tormented with those. Up until the time that my daughter was actually born. And when she was about 6 months old, I wasn't afraid to kill myself. I was so tormented that I just wanted to die. Wow. And nobody knew. My family didn't know. My husband didn't know. Nobody knew.
So you were suffering in silence.
Yes, I was. And I actually told somebody about wanting to kill myself, and it was because of my daughter that I didn't, because I just had a thought in my mind, what's gonna happen to your baby if she wakes up and she doesn't have a mama? And that was too heartbreaking for me, and so I couldn't do it. But the person told me to watch Reverend Angley's program, and because Reverend Angley was preaching on something and they had been trying it, and that is praising God, because the Lord inhabits the praises of his people, and so he comes closer to you when you praise him. And so I started doing that, and then had the opportunity to go to the cathedral buffet, which was open to the public at the time, and somebody, while I was there, invited me to go to the church.
Wonderful.
And so the first time I went to Grace Cathedral, my daughter was less than a year old. And before I ever sat through the service, I felt the love of God pour into my heart. And it was what I was looking for my whole life. I was searching for that love that I found, and it was God.
Did you feel like you finally came home?
Yeah, I felt like this is what I've been looking for my whole life. This is where I have to be. Mm-hmm. And so I wanted to be there as much as I could. And I did. I brought my daughter up there, and she went through the Sunday school. I don't know if she got all the way through the Sunday school before I started letting the cares of life, other people's opinions, even my own opinions, get in the way of seeking hard after the Lord. And so I fell away, and I didn't even realize it. I didn't even realize that when you go away from the Lord, even just a little bit, you don't just stay there, you continue moving away because you're not moving closer. Mm-hmm. And it wasn't until I was really in sin and the Lord sent someone after me from Grace Cathedral that I had known while I was there previously into my place of employment. And I felt that love again come through her. And I got to hug her before she left, and it was just wonderful. I felt like I want to go home, but I was kind of afraid to go to the church yet. But she kept coming to visit me once a month or once every couple of months. And so the Lord kept bringing that back around, and it made me desire Him more than the sin that I was in. And so I knew that I had to get out of the situation of sin that I was in. And the Lord made that possible because He knew in my heart that I wanted Him,
right,
even though I wasn't back to Him yet. And He moved in a miraculous, wonderful, very quick way, which I couldn't have orchestrated myself. And He showed me a lot of love and compassion. And then, of course, the sin doesn't leave you alone. The devil doesn't want you to find God, even if you had Him before. And there was another episode. And after, it crushed me so much in my heart. But I realized that I couldn't come to the Lord on my own, that I couldn't save myself. Mm-hmm. And so I just knelt down by my bed and poured out my heart to God. And I asked Jesus to come into my life and to be everything to me. And He did, and it changed my life.
Yeah.
And then He worked to get me back to Grace Cathedral. And Grace Cathedral is the place that I want to be most, except for heaven.
Right.
And that comes after we get the work done. Mm-hmm. But it just, it's where God's love is. It's where God's word is preached uncompromisingly. And it's where God's people gather and share His love and His anointing. And it's a family closer than any earth family, because it's the family of God.
Yes, this is true.
And it's just wonderful. And I love being a part of Grace Cathedral. It's my life.
Well, we love having you a part of Grace Cathedral. And we're so grateful that you finally came home.
Me too. Me too.
And that's the beauty of salvation.
It is.
When you reach out to God, it doesn't matter where you're at.
Right.
You just drop to your knees and cry out to God.
Yes.
And He was there
to save you. Yes, He was.
That's wonderful.
Yes, Anna. This was a beautiful testimony, and it's just like the prodigal son in the Bible.
Yes.
Where he went to his father, and his father ran to him.
Yes.
God's going to run to you with open arms, friend. But you have to receive Him into your heart. Just think, you can receive Jesus Christ right now by praying with me. Say, "Oh God, save my soul. Forgive me for my sins. But I have come home to serve you the rest of my life. And I believe that the blood of Jesus washes away all of my sins. Come into my heart, Jesus. Come on in, Jesus. Amen. Friend, now that you have Jesus Christ in your heart, serve him with your whole heart. Right before Jesus told this parable about the prodigal son, he mentions that the angels in heaven were rejoicing when one soul repenteth. Not many souls, just one soul. I pray that you're that one soul today, that you receive Jesus Christ in your heart. What a blessing it is to receive Jesus Christ.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is.
Well, this was a wonderful testimony that you had.
Thank you.
And God has blessed you, and we're blessed to have you at Grace Cathedral.
It is such an honor. It's such an honor.
Thank you, Anna, for sharing your testimony and how God delivered you.
You're welcome. It was a blessing, and I do pray that the backsliders come home, because there's no place like home.
True. There's no place like home.
There is. No place like home. Well, friend, stay with us, and we'll be back in a moment. God bless you.
He wants us to be filled to the brim with His greatness.
Friend, come be with us at 10 a.m. We look forward to seeing you.
If you are enjoying today's program, let us know by sending in a donation. Your gift of love will enable others to be lifted up into the grace of God.
Loved having you with us today. In the Bible, the Lord says, "Is there anything too hard for me?" Friend, there's nothing too hard for the Lord.
And the Bible also says that God is married to the backslider. So if you've drifted away, come home today. Come home to Jesus. We look forward to seeing you later on today at 10 o'clock at Grace Cathedral if you can be with us. If not, we'll see you next time. God bless.
If this program has blessed you today, let us know on our Facebook page. You're also invited to attend any of our services. Come and witness the wonderful things of heaven for yourself. This program has been made possible by the friends and partners of Ernest Angley Ministries.